Here on Meet the Press with the Home Affairs Minister, Jason Clare. And it's welcome to the panel, Mark Kenny, the advertiser, and Jessica Wright from the National Times.
Good morning
to you both.
Morning, Paul.
Kevin Rudd and Julia Gillard were at one during the week, agreeing to a boycott of the Ellen Jones show.
No, I would not. I haven't spoken to Mr. Jones and I don't intend to.
I certainly won't be going on it, and usually for my better health over the years, I've not listened to it either.
The grotesque sucking up to Ellen Jones by Kevin Rudd on his program was slightly vomitous when he was Leader of the Opposition.
Vomitous. Minister, you used to work for Bob Carr. He, of course, fated Ellen Jones when he was Premier. How important is that Western Sydney Struggle Street market to Labor, and can you really afford to ignore it?
Well, I represent Western Sydney, so I know how important the issues are in Western Sydney. But this is not about a market. It's not about an audience. It doesn't matter whether you've got 10 people watching or 10 million people. It's not about politics. It's about standards. You don't pick on people's families, you don't pick on people's parents or their children, particularly if they've just passed away. Particularly, you don't pick on people who can't respond. So this is a question about standards.
But he's had a long record of saying controversial things. Is this just the last straw, and will you be boycotting the program? Is that what you're saying today?
Well, I think there's a difference between having a go at politicians, we're fair game, but having a go at families. You should leave families out of it. Once we go down the path where you start attacking families, you're not going to get the right people getting involved in politics. If you'd asked me that question a couple of weeks ago, I'd say yes, but now I want to see standards improve.
Well, Minister, on the Bolt report this morning, Tony Abbott explained why his wife, Margie, has entered the political fray. He says it's to counter a Labor smear campaign against him. Here he is.
This is typical of the contemporary Labor Party. When you can't defend your record, when you've got nothing of substance to say, you go personal, and that's what they've been doing.
Minister, well, is this the end for the handbag hit squad? Or will Labor ignore Tony Abbott and continue with the Tony Abbott has a problem with the women folk?
Well, let's get real here. Politicians are going to be judged on what they say and what they do, and Tony Abbott's got a long record of saying some pretty extreme, some pretty out there things. You want my view? My view is that what's more important than what you watch on television is what you're going to do. And if you look at what Tony Abbott would do if he was Prime Minister, it'd mean that he'd cut the pension for millions of pensioners. He would increase income tax for 7 million Australians. They're the sorts of things that are important to ordinary Australians. Tony Abbott says, what about Labor's record? Well, I'd point him to the fact that unemployment here is half what it is in France and most of the rest of Europe,
and interest rates. This is a very specific argument that you're pushing. You're pushing that Tony Abbott has a problem with women. Is this cynical politics at its best? Julia Gillard's polling doesn't show she does too well with men. Is it time to wheel out Tim, or is it time to argue the case based on politics, not gender?
Oh, well, look, Tim's been out there before. I'm sure he will again. Mrs. Abbott's been out there before. I'm sure she will again. I make two points, and that is that politicians are going to be judged on what they say and do, and Mr. Abbott needs to expect to be judged on some of the extreme things that he said in the past. But more importantly, people need to know what Tony Abbott would do as Prime Minister, and things like cutting the pension and increasing income tax are pretty extreme things that people need to be aware of.
Minister, in your capacity as the Minister for Defence Materiel, can I ask you a question about the
Sure.
air warfare destroyer? There's talk of a fourth vessel being built to bridge the skills gap to the Future Submarines project. How realistic is that, and can we afford it?
It's a good question. We're building three big warships at the moment in Adelaide, as well as in Melbourne and in Newcastle. That wraps up at about the end of this decade. Then we build submarines after that, but there's a gap between the warships and between the submarines, what people call the Valley of Death. And I think we do need to build a bridge across this Valley of Death to make sure that we retain the workers and the skills to build what are very complicated military weapons. Submarines are like underwater spaceships. We need a lot of skill to build them. So we're looking now at what we need to fill the gap to make sure that we retain those skilled workers in Adelaide as well as in other parts of the country so that we can build the submarine.
And presumably you'd need to do that fairly early, give the industry a lot of notice that that's going to be
the
case,
right,
so they can retain those skills?
Yeah. Defence, myself and Australian defence industry are working on a plan to do this right now. They'll present it to me in December, and that'll then be fed into the defence white paper that will be released in the first half of next year.
Just quickly on Peter Slipper, given the controversy surrounding him, is he really viable now as a speaker to return to that job as chief protector and umpire of standards in the parliament?
Well, that's a matter for the parliament to decide. They'll have to make that decision once the court case that's in the court at the moment is decided.
Well, Minister, thank you very much for being with us this morning.
Thanks, Paul.
Coming up after the break, Wilson Tuckey talks about the revolt in WA against the federal coalition. Tony Abbott feels under siege. Everybody's blaming him.
The government blames me for everything. Someone gets a flat tyre on the way to work. Well, that's Tony Abbott's fault.
No, see, the
that's
thing
true.
Is,
I had
a flat tyre on the way to work this morning and I naturally blamed the carbon tax.